Good afternoon. Okay, so today is Wednesday, August 30th. So we have today and tomorrow left in August. I finished over the weekend. Let me. Quite a few books. I finished in this order. Anything but typical, which was the August selection for Autism Reads. Link is always in the description box. I read The Fine Print by Lauren Asher. Loved this book. And then I finished yesterday, read it in 2 days. I finished Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. So this is book two in the Harry Potter world. This one's in a slipcase and it has Dobby and foiling on the cover. So, and this, what's interesting because I was listening to the audiobook on this. The audiobook, I think, is the American English edition. This particular edition, or in these editions with the slipcase, they are the UK English edition. So there are some variations as far as certain phrasings and words, but it's not too bad. You still understand it. What are some examples? I can't think right off the top of my head, but certain words that mean the same thing, but it's a different word. For example, like we say trunk for the trunk of a car. In England, they say boot for the same thing. So it's similar, although that word didn't come up, but it's similar. One thing I did learn about this reread, this is like my third time rereading this particular book. And the first reread, so I read it physically on the original hardback edition in the US. And then the second time I read it, I listened via audiobook to and from work, when I was actually having to go into the office. So, but this time I actually learned that, and it's amazing what you can pick up after so many rereads with a book. I learned that Gilderoy Lockhart in this book is actually Armenian. So that was interesting. I didn't realize that. Anyway, so I have been wanting to pick up, oh, and I finished Enter the Witch, my ebook that I was reading. It was a novella. I finished that one and I enjoyed that. I got the second book, so that's on my Kindle, ready to go when I'm ready to get back into that world. I started Journey on my ebook by, I can't remember his name, Gary V. Bile Bills, I don't know. It is a historical fiction. We're following the perspective, it's told in third person, and we're following James, is his name. James is black. And there is a lot of racism in this book, but this was written at the time at kind of in the midst of the Revolutionary War. So we're fighting, he's in America, we're fighting England and stuff like that. So the N-word, like N like November, and I'm not gonna say the word, pops up a lot. Like so far, I'm only 36% of the way through or something like that. And that N-word has popped up 24 times. So it pops up quite a bit, but you have to remember when this was set, which during revolutionary times, that word was thrown out a lot, and it was done so in such a derogatory, demeaning way. James we're following was born free, so he was born in America, his parents were free, and so he's black, but he's a free black man. And so you can see the difference between him and those that are raised as slaves, which is interesting. And it's in his thinking, but he's still, people during this time with the slavery and stuff, they don't care if you were born free or whatever the case is, if you're a free black man. You have slavers that are present in this, and so they will go and kidnap someone who's black. They don't care if you say you're free and you own the land that you live on and can provide documentation. They will kidnap you and sell you across a river. And so now you're a slave. So, and that actually happened to James's younger brother. We do find that out quite early on. Even though he is a free man, he's basically only free during daylight hours. So he is not supposed to be on the streets at dark. They say it's because he's harder to see him because he's black, which is just so such a stupid thing. And it's like, I can't believe the thinking that went on back then. But I'm glad it's definitely not, I know there's racism that still exists, but I'm glad it's not as it was back then, if that makes sense. Anyway, it is hard to read because of how in your face it is, but it's James's life. He's a black man. It's very much in his face. He's living in the thick of it. So it is understandable. Anyway, so I'm still reading that. I actually am really enjoying it. I was a little nervous going into it, but I am enjoying it. The physical book I started this morning is this one that just says Dom and Becca, but the title of the book, which is on the inside, because this is the Discreet series, is Dirty Dom. This is a spicy, and we've already had an open door sex scene, and in the prologue. So right off the bat, it is rougher with the language. I am now on page 18. I'm in the middle of chapter one, and the F-bomb has popped up already 71 times. So do be aware it is that. And the author is Willow Winters. This is my first time reading a Willow Winters book, and I am enjoying it so far. So right now, crap's hitting the fan. There was an attempted murder that just took place. So anyway, I have moved the, so this is the start of a new weekly vlog. I have moved the footage from my camera to my little USB thing so I can, when I'm done with the video I'm trying to edit, then I can edit this week's vlog and get it up for tomorrow, hopefully. So, but I'm working on a sweet romance haul right now. So gonna be working on that. I have a lot of stuff to do today, so I don't know how much reading I'm going to get done. I would love to finish this book today, but there's over 200 pages. With the epilogue, it is 228 pages. I mean, I could definitely do it, but there's no audiobook available for this. Willow Winters does have a YouTube channel where she does shorts. And there are like three or four books that she has written that she does have the audiobooks available on YouTube, but this one is not, unfortunately, one of them. And this is, I thought this was a standalone, but this is actually number one in a series. I didn't look all that much into it before I bought it. This is book number one in the Valetti Crime Family series, and there are five books in this series. So working on that, I would love to finish it today, but I don't think that's possible. I hope to at the very least finish it tomorrow so I can start off September with one of my September reads. So I've got a lot to do. I'm going to try to read a chapter of Dirty Dom in between each task because the chapters really are not that long. So like I have to call in a prescription. I have to call and take care of an ENT bill. I've got an ambulance bill. I've got a hearing aid bill. I've got all this stuff to take care of. So I'm going to do one thing and then I'll read a chapter is my plan. So it'll be a process and then we'll just go from there. But so far, that's really all I have. This coming week on Monday is Labor Day here in the United States. So I unfortunately have to work that day. But the bonus is that because I do normally do 4 10-hour shifts. The bonus is when I have to work due to a holiday on one of my normal days off. Instead of 4 10-hour shifts, it goes down to 5 8-hour shifts. So the days are not quite as long. I do feel like I get done with my shift a bit sooner. So that's the only update I have for you right now. When I have more, I'll obviously check back in. I'm a little overwhelmed with how much stuff I have to do, but that's life. And I'm just going to take it slow and take it easy. Thank you. Hello. Okay, so it's 11:27 on Thursday. Got some prompts that were released for two readathons where the prompts were not going to be released until the start of September. Well, September starts tomorrow. Today is the last day of August. So I had to make sure that the first book I pick up for those two other readathons were not part of the Killer versus Final Girls readathon. And the book I'm picking, the first book I'm picking to pick up is not. So, and I'm only going to go with one. I'm going to go only pick a book. And then when I finish that one, then I'll look at the next prompt and then pick a book. So that's how I think I'm going to do that. So for the Sufferathon Hotel, the book that was, or the prompt that was released is to read a book with illustrations. I'm going with the middle grade, and this is Dork Diaries, Volume 4. Tales from a Not So Graceful Ice Princess. This is written in journal format. And there are illustrations. So this will definitely count. It's a quick read. So this will count, be my first book for Sephirothon. Now, the Monsters University, they released the prompts a day early. They released them today. So they've released four prompts. And the first one is to read a book with an object on the cover that a child would like. Well, a lot of children would like ice skates because they have fun going and ice skating. Maybe some of them want to be an ice skater. So anyway, so this will count for the first prompt for the Monsters University Readathon. So that's the first book I'm going to go with. I have it set in the perfect spot. I can just grab it tomorrow. Prompt number two for Monsters University. I'm not going to pick a book yet. I will pick a book after I've read the Dork Diaries number four. So prompt number two for Monsters University Readathon is a book that has something on the cover that you would never give a child. That's going to be a little bit more difficult. I mean, not really. Like, I could go with A Time of Blood. I would never give a child a knife, that especially unsupervised, and depending on the age of the child, you know, I would not give a child a knife. So, you know, it's not like it, the whole thing has to be. So that's an idea. But that, I think, is on my Killers versus Final Girls. It is. It's on my list for Killers versus Final Girls, and that readathon doesn't start until the 2nd. So we'll see what I do, or if I have to find a different book or something. So I could go with another manga and for the Monsters University one, you know, that way it's such another quick read for the day. Anyway, we'll see when I get to that prompt. We'll see. The third prompt, they've released four. So the third one is the child is an important or main part of the story. So I do have a Mary Downing Hahn book, which is in middle grade, and the children are the main part of her stories. So that'll work for there. That's what I'm leaning towards. So I kind of have a tentative idea for that one. But again, we will see. And then prompt number four is a random letter generator. So I will do that when I get to it. So yeah, so at least we have the prompts for to kick off Sephirothon and for Monsters University. Now, as far as the ebook I am currently reading, which is Journey, I am on, I don't know what page, 25% of the way through, which is page 76 of 308. So, just working on that a little bit at a time. As far as Dirty Dom, ooh, this is very rough. Very, very rough. This is a mafia. It's a mafia family. And it is, we've already had, let's see, off at three open door sex instances. And it is extremely rough. The language is very rough. So do be aware of that. So like I am on page 101. So I've read 100 pages and the F-bomb has already popped up 335 times. So the language is very, very rough. Do be aware of that. So anyway, that's what I'm currently reading and working on. I am trying to get the magical autumn equinox reading wrap up uploaded to YouTube and scheduled. I tried to do it on one of my new computer because I had to get a new computer. And right now it's just like processing will begin shortly and it keeps abandoning the upload process. And so I'm not sure what's going on there. So I'm trying to get it on my work computer to see if it'll work there. And as of right now, it's 19 minutes left for uploading. So it's uploaded to YouTube, uploaded, but it still has to process on my personal computer. So I'm not sure which one, what's going on there, but yeah, I don't know. I still have a lot of videos to edit. I have at least 10 videos. You can't see them, but all these memory cards. Yeah, you can't see them. But I have like 10 of them to edit, but it's just, I can edit and upload. I can't edit and upload at the same time. So it's just going to take a process. So I'm going to get to work and go from there. Happy September 1st. It is 10:06 in the morning. I've been working for a little bit. I did finish this morning Dirty Dom by Willow Winters. I filmed the review and now I've got that book put away. So September 1st, let's talk readathons. Oh my heck. Okay. So I am going to pick up, so I'm still working on Journey, but that's my ebook, and I don't think that's going to fit. Okay, so the book I'm going to start today is Dork Diaries, Volume Number 4. This is Tales from a Not-So-Graceful Ice Princess. This is a middle grade. It's told in diary format, and there's drawings in there because she draws in her diary. And the main character's name that we are following is Nikki, and she's in middle school, so we're following her life as she goes through school. This is not a selection from my catwalk. Let's see. Killers versus Final Girl starts tomorrow. Seasonathon Academy starts today, but it is not a selection I have for that. Okay. This will work for Monsters University. I did get these prompts yesterday. So they were released a day early. Prompt number one is a book with an object on the cover that a child would like. So I'm saying ice skates. Several children would love ice skates. I wanted ice skates when I was a child. So I'm going to say ice skates. Oh, and I think I forgot to say this was written by Rachel Renee Russell. So again, this will work for the first prompt for the Monsters University readathon. Next up is the Sufferathon Hotel. So the prompt was also released yesterday. And the prompt is book with illustrations. Well, as I showed you, this has illustrations in it. So yay, this works for two readathons. Okay, and this actually works for a third readathon that I'm doing. I'm doing like six readathons. Battle of the Secret Societies. This one's on Discord. I am part of Team Skull and Bones, and this is for the class of General Studies. This is a book that has a school setting. This takes place, a lot of this will take place in the school. She's dealing with a school bully. There's probably a field trip in here, but yeah, at some point, these have always, at least the first three books have taken place a large part at school at some point in the book. So I am saying that this one will work. If it does not, I'll end up having to find a different book. Let me actually see if I can find out for sure. So this is starting out on December 1st in the book. So it's taking place at home because that's a Sunday according to this book. Okay, so chapter two, diary entry number two is Monday, December 2nd. And the first line is, I'm totally dreading seeing Brandon in school today. And then here's an image of them in gym class. So at some point, a couple times in this book, it does take place at school. So school setting, that works. Now with the Battle of the Secret Societies, it is point based. So the rules, it needs to be 200 or more pages. This definitely is. It is 300 and... ...46. Okay, so 10 points is this fulfills a non-team prompt, and the team prompt is for archaeology. So this is a non-team prompt, so that's 10 points. And then it's based off, okay, so 5 points of the books is outside of prompts, but this does count for a prompt. So 10 points, and so I'm gonna write that down. And then you get points off of page count. So you get five additional points if the book is over 350 pages. And unfortunately, this is just shy of that mark. So all I get is 10 points because this is 347 pages. So close to the 350 page mark, but 10 points, that's still points for my team. So I've been sitting here working and it hit me. So I've been trying to participate in Battle of the Buccaneers, which is hosted by the Tilted Kettle Book Club on Discord. And I've been stuck on prompt number three, which is Sailing the Seven Seas. This is to read a book that contains a heist. And I was thinking like it had to be something on a ship or some big thing like trying to steal the grand jewels or something. And then it hit me. I did read a book that contains a heist. Now, granted, it's a botched and failed heist, but it's still a heist. And that is Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, because someone breaks into Gringotts to try to steal the Philosopher's Stone, but it's failed because the stone was moved before. And then the second heist is more of the whole big thing where Harry, Ron, and Hermione go to the third floor corridor and then through the trap door that Fluffy protects. And, you know, they have to do the find the key, you know, and they have to do the life-size wizarding chest, Snape's potions, Professor Sprout's devil's snare type of a thing. So they have to go through all of that. And of course, you know, Harry meets the man with the two faces and all of that. Because he's trying to steal the Philosopher's Stone. So that is a heist. So I'm counting that. So I'm gonna write that down and then I can add the next prompt. So for the Monsters University readathon, prompt number one was to read a book with an object on the cover that a child would like. As I had mentioned, I did Dork Diaries because it has the ice skates on the cover. So this goes by points as well. So it's 100 points per book. So that's 100 points. 50 points per prompt, one book per prompt. So that's 50 points because I fulfilled the prompt. It does not fit the team genre because I'm on team, is it Hess or something like that? But it's team horror thriller. So this is definitely not that. I would not consider this a diverse read. And there is no door on the cover, so no points for that. But 50 points for something funny in the book. Well, she falls a lot, ice skating, they dress as clowns. There's a thing involving the Nutcracker. This takes place in December, so there are several funny incidences in this. So 50 points, so I got 200 points for this book. So moving on, and this also worked for the prompt for Sufferathon, which is a book with illustrations. This is in diary format and there's illustrations in it. And then I think this worked for one other readathon. Which one was it? Battle of the Secret Societies. This worked for General Studies, which is a book that has a school setting at points. This does take place in a school. They're standing in a locker. It's during gym class. So there is a school setting in this book. So that worked for that. And as far as points, this only gets 10 points because it fulfills a non-team prompt because the team prompt is for archaeology. So this is not the team prompt. So 10 points, and it is just shy of the 350 page mark to get any additional points. And so, yeah, so 10 points. But yes, and I enjoyed this, and I liked, there was one thing in here I highlighted, and it is, a true friend is someone who thinks you're a good egg, even when you're slightly cracked. So, okay, so the next prompt for Monsters University is a book that has something on the cover that you would never give a child. I am going to go with a weapon. So like a bow and arrow, or because there's bows and arrows here, or is that a knife or something? I don't know, but some kind of weapon, sword. It's weapons. I would never give a child a weapon. So this will count for that. And let's see. So it'll be 100 points plus 50 because it fits the prompt. I don't remember if this is a diverse read or not. There is no door on the cover. And I don't know about something funny. So at the very least, I'll get 150 points for this book. So I'm going to start this today. And yeah, and I'm sure, and that'll fit some prompts for other ones. Now, the other prompt number three is for the Monsters University Readathon, is there the child or a child as an important or main part of the story. I'm going to go with Virtual Unicorn Experience by Dina Simpson on this. It's a child. And it's about Phoebe and her relationship. They're just going on different adventures. So that definitely fits that. The fourth prompt of this first grouping that was released is a random generator. So I am pulling that up on my computer here. So let's go ahead and figure out what the letter is that will be generated. Okay, so I have a random, just did a Google search for random letter generator. And I'm just going to go to this first one here. Okay, so it loaded with E, and we're going to generate a random number. I don't care about lowercase or capital. I don't care. It's still the same letter. Okay, so a C. I need a book that starts with the letter C, like my name, Christine. So something that starts with C. Okay, so I went to Discord for the Monsters University Readathon, and the random letter generator can either be the title starts with that letter, which again, I got C, like Christine, or the author's name. And I'm going to go with that. The author's name starts with the letter C. So I have three options. I can do Agatha Christie, and then there were none. The Girl from Raw Blood by Katarina Ward. Katarina starts with the C. Or I can do Books of Blood, Volume 1 by Clive Barker. You know what? I'm going to say it's either going to be between, okay, between Books of Blood and The Girl from Raw Blood. I'm being drawn more to Girl from Raw Blood by Katarina Ward. So that's the book I'm going to use for that. Good afternoon. It is Monday, September 4th. It is Labor Day, so I have to work today. Thankfully, it's only an 8-hour shift, so I started at 9:30. I'll be off at 6, so I have the evening to read. Tomorrow, the only appointment I have is to go and get my haircut again. So I'm going to do that, and I think I'm going to go shorter, but I'll talk to her and see if, to the hairstylist and see if, because it's at the length that's starting to bug me, so it will be shorter. We'll see. I mean, obviously you will see after it's cut. So see if she thinks it's a good cut for like my face structure. Okay. So I am currently still working on A Time of Blood by John Gwynne. I have ordered the third book because I absolutely love John Gwynne's writing, and I know I'm going to read the third book. This is sitting at a 5-star for me so far. I'm on page 290, so I have less than 200 pages left. So I will finish this today. Found another readathon. Surprise, surprise, Adventure-a-thon. I saw this on Ren's channel, Reading with Ren. I probably said that channel name wrong, but I saw this on that channel, and went through and watched everything. Basically, you're choosing what you want to be for this adventure. So the first one I am working on is, crap, I can't remember. I mean, there's a couple of different things you can work on to be. Well, for example, an inventor. Or my pages are stuck together. A blacksmith, which is what Ren is doing. And then I think she's going to do a minstrel after that. So, blacksmith, minstrel, I just said that one. A spy. I would love to get more than one of these done, but we'll see. Like, I would love to become a necromancer. One of them is a seer. But the one I'm working on first is warlock. And so you choose your tools. So you can do an amulet or a spell. I'm going to do both. So for an amulet, it is a book with jewelry on the cover. So Dork Diaries number 4 that I read, where it's like tales of a not so graceful ice princess. She's in her skating costume and she actually has earrings, and you can see the earrings on the cover. So got that one. And then the second one is spell casting. This is to read a book with smoke on the cover. There's smoke on the cover. It's red smoke, but it's still smoke. It's smoke. So, smoke on the cover. And then you're into choose your skills. So there's curses, shadow magic, invocation, and invocation. So curses is to read a book with a cursed character, cursed place, or a cursed object. Shadow magic is to read a dark fantasy or romance. Invocation is a pull pick. I'm going to try to do all three. I just love to do that. So, I will probably do a poll on Instagram. So, you which you will the Instagram the poll will have already been live and all of that, but I'm sure by the time you see this video, more than likely, but we'll see. And then you have the side quest. So, starting a quest, you have the for Warlock is to read a book from a villain's point of view. And then you have side quests. So one is to gather your power. This is a strong female main character. Side quest number 2 is not all warlocks are evil. This is to read a good book that has a not so great cover, so a bad cover type of a situation. Number 3 is to acknowledge your patron, and this is to read a book with fae, demons, or angels. And then side quest number 4 is Dark Pursuits. This is to read a book by candlelight or fairy lights. I do have rose-shaped fairy lights on my headboard on my bed, so I will do that. And number 5 is Small Yet Powerful Spells. This is to read a short read, so a book that is under 200 pages. Definitely can do that. And then the final one for Warlock is the final quest, and this is to read a book that has a hero corruption arc. So that's my main priority is to do for the Warlock. And then I'm debating if I want to do seer or necromancer next if I have time. So, but I did write them all down just in case. But yeah, so I, yeah. And then this notebook, I mean, I tear them out and recycle the pages when I'm done with the TBRs. But this notebook's done pretty much, is done. I cannot put any more into this. Now, there's already a readathon that will be taking place in October. It's a trick or treat readathon. Or trick or treat-a-thon. That is on Discord. There is an Instagram as well. So I have signed up for that. They've given prompt teasers. I don't know what the prompts are with the, like, one could be candy haul or I don't know, but something like that. But you don't know what the actual prompt is for that prompt term. So still keeping an eye out on that. Still have yet to be sorted. I've signed up, but I have not been sorted into my team yet. There's like team monster, team scary, team sweet, team. There's like 4 or 5 teams. So waiting on that. And then once the prompts dr officially dropped, I think you can make a bingo board. So I would work on that. So that's the only one I know of as of right now for October. which I'm definitely planning on participating in that. The other thing I have going on tomorrow, aside from my hair, is I do need to go, one, I need to go to the bank and withdraw some money so that I can pay the technician in preferably cash, or the hair tech, and get money to do my nails next week, because next week will be the 2 weeks. We have someone coming over at some point today to do an estimate. My mom and I want to convert in the shared bathroom that we have upstairs. We want to convert the bathtub shower because it's a shower bath combo. I mean, both of us, I'm going to be 40 in December, and both of us are obviously not getting any younger. And so for safety reasons, my mom wants to see what it would cost to convert that to only a shower that has like a bench that you can sit on. So we're thinking about doing that. We'll see what it costs and things like that. But I'm going to tell her, go ahead and do it, because for safety reasons, and both of us are pretty klutzy and accident prone. So it'd be good to have that to where we're not having to step over a big lip to shower and stuff for that. So I'm hoping she does that. So yeah, that's the update for now. And I'll update you again if I can, but who knows what the day is going to be like today. I'm about to go ahead and just get in my pajamas. I'm not going to worry about going down to film a review for this. I haven't finished it yet. I just had some dinner. So we're calling it good. Now, I did see Paige from Pages with Paige posted the update for the prompts for the Sufferathon, Hotel Readathon. So there's two things to do. One is, it says you need to read the same genre or a book that is compared to the book that you gave the lowest rating to within the last 2 years. Well, what book came to my mind immediately with the lowest rating within the past 2 years? Actually, I think it was this year. I gave 1 star to Heartstopper. And that is a romance. So I am going to read a romance. This one is Someone Just Like You by Meredith Score, and it's a romance. So same genre. Now, but so I'm still trying to do the Monsters Readathon too. So After a Time of Blood, this will cover something on the cover. The prompt is something on the cover. A book that has something on the cover that you would never give to a child. I'd never give a child a sword or a weapon. Okay. And then prompt number 3 is, the child is an important or main part of the story. For that one, I'm going with a graphic novel, virtual unicorn experience. This is number 12 in the Phoebe and Her Unicorn series. And then prompt number 4 for the Monsters University Readathon is random letter generator. And I got the letter C. And so I'm going with The Girl from Raw Blood by Katarina Ward. So there's the C, it's in the author's name. So I think what I'll do is after I finish A Time of Blood, I will go ahead and read the manga. And then I will switch to the romance, Someone Just Like You, to make sure I fulfill prompt 1 for this week for the Sufferathon. And then I will do Girl from Raw Blood. So that's my plan. But there is another part to this. So for Sufferathon, we have to roll a D6 dice because we have to figure out what room we're going to be in. And so we have to roll a D6 dice. And so I have my dice here, taking out my metal magnets. I've got my tray here. It has 2 dice in there, but we only need 1. So I'm going to roll the dice. If it lands on an even number, then we read for 2 hours a day. And if I land on an odd number, it's 1 hour a day. I was going to try and make this more complicated, but this video came out 2 days ago. So Saturday, because today's Monday, so I need to read for Saturday, Sunday, and then Monday. So, and of course I haven't been timing. I know I've read at least the 1 hour, but I don't know for sure. So let's roll the dice and then I'll come back and kind of tell you what I'm going to do. Okay, so here's the dice, and let's see, let me take my, easier to do this without the hand thing there. An odd number, oh sweet, okay, so it's a 1. Okay, So what I'm going to do is on my notebook that I'm writing this down, I wrote down that I rolled a number one. So that's to read 1 hour a day. So I'm going to write down the days of the week, Saturday through Friday. And then I'm going to put a check mark for when I do that. So Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Now, with today being Monday, I obviously didn't see the video that Pages with Paige put up until today. And today's Monday. So we're posted 2 days ago. I'm going to set a timer on my phone and I'm going to read for 1 hour and that will tick off Saturday. And then I'll read for another hour and that will tick off Sunday. Then I'll read for another hour and do Monday. This will be easy. I can definitely read. I definitely read generally more than 1 hour a day, but there are some days where I don't do any reading or very little, depending on how busy it is or if physically, if I'm feeling good or having a bad day or not. So I'm still going to keep track. So I have 2 hours to catch up on is what I'm going to say, and I'm going to catch up on those hours. So because I want to make sure I get this, that's what I will do. And if I read over the 3 hours that I'm going to do, so Saturday, Sunday, Monday, that's 3 hours, 1 hour a day. If I read 5 hours in a day, or let's say I get caught up and then like tomorrow I only read 3 hours, but I only needed to read the one, I'm not going to carry over the extra hours the other day. Each day will be for 1 hour. It could just kind of starts fresh. So that's, I think, what I'm going to do. So I'm going to set the timer on my phone. I have, I think, an hour and a half left of this. So that'll cover Saturday right there. But yeah, I'll obviously keep you posted. And as prompts get dropped for not only Sephirothon Hotel, but the Monsters University, which I haven't seen any additional prompts yet. I did check today, but I have not seen any additional prompts since the original four that they dropped. So as soon as I see those, obviously I will let you know. Whether or not that's in this vlog or not, that I can't tell you, but we'll see. I am home from my appointment. What do you think of my hair? It is so much shorter, but oh man, the back of my neck feels so good. So we'll see. It'll take some getting used to, but anyway. So the next round of prompts dropped for Monsters University. So the first group of four prompts was, the challenge was for giggles. So more humorous type stuff. Challenge number two is to avoid the parents. So prompt number one for challenge two is to read a book where the parent is never there, is never home or there for their child. Number two is to read a book that you would never read to a child. That's a pretty easy one, because if it's a steamy romance, I'm never reading that to a child. Number three is to read a book in a POV of a parent or guardian, basically. And then number four is to read a book that you think will have a parent's worst nightmare. I'm guessing like child kidnapping or child death is what my mind goes to. But we'll see kind of what happens there. So those are the updates. I got my hair done. I am overstimulated from being at the hairdresser. I am planning on, so I have an appointment in 9 weeks to get another haircut. So just to like, you know, trim it up. I'm also thinking about doing what's called low lights to kind of bring out some copper color. My hair used to be a very pretty strawberry blonde when I was little, and as I've gotten older, it's just gotten darker. And the stylist said that's pretty natural for people, especially if they have any blonde, for the hair to get darker over time. So, and I'm wondering how long I'll have my curls, because I got my curls, my hair used to be straight. When I hit puberty, my hair curled. And so I'm wondering, as I get older and my hormones start to change again, if my hair will go to straight. So I don't know. We'll see what happens. Hair is a funny thing sometimes. So I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog here, because I am overstimulated and I just want to get in some, I'm going to go ahead and get my pajamas. Granted, it's only 2 o'clock, but I don't care. I've got to have restrictive clothing off, because it's like there's not as much give in this as there is in my pajamas. So I'm going to change them into my pajamas. Plus it's hot, and so it'll be a lot cooler. And I'm just going to lay around and read. Oh, before I do let you go, though, I did get some book mail today. So I ordered the third book in Of Blood and Bone by John Gwynn, so A Time of Courage. I did finish the second one last night, so I'll have that one ready to go when I'm ready to be back in that world. And then I also had pre-ordered Addicted After All by Krista and Becca Ritchie, and so this arrived today. So I'm wondering, the last one I read by Krista and Becca Ritchie had a playlist. I'm wondering if there's a playlist in this one too. Let's see, there's a questionnaire. Oh, bonus scenes is what it is. Another bonus, an interview, text message thread. Oh, yep, there is a playlist. So I'm hoping all of the books by Krista and Becca Ritchie have playlists. I've enjoyed listening to the two playlists that I've got, one from them and one from, I'm blanking on her name, but it's the billionaire one, Dreamland Billionaire series. There was a playlist in that, and I'm really enjoying that one. So yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog here so that I can just, I'm going to go ahead and shut my blind, and then I can just be quiet and have some cool air and just relax. Because, I mean, all the talking, the brightness at the salon, the hair dryer, I just said I'm going to air dry my hair. I didn't ever use the blow dryer, but other people were using the blow dryer. It's very overstimulating for me. And so I am like on edge, and I need to relax so I don't have a meltdown. So I'm going to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and end this vlog here. I hope you guys are doing well and having some good reads. So talk to me in the comments section below. And until next time, stay true to yourself and enjoy a good book. And I'll talk to you later.